Hello, YouTube audience. Today, I would like to do the initial styling on this Carocia cotoneasta, or wire netting bush. So I have seen fairly little wire netting bush bonsai on the internet, but as you can see, it is such an ideal subject. So all these movements in the branches, they are all the natural growing habit from this plant. So you almost, it's called wire netting bush, so you almost don't need to wire it. It just naturally grow in such a crazy way. And I think this plant, this species is originally from Australia, and it is a semi-evergreen in temperate climate zones such as Seattle. And here we kind of enters fall already, and there are a little bit rain that's happening. But I think we can get started, because I'm not going to do a repot. I'm simply going to tease the root a little bit to kind of see where the root base is. I suspect this was initially, so the surface root is, so the first step of creating a bonsai is to expose the surface root and see where the root base is, and based on the root base, people can normally select a so-called front of the tree. So normally people believe the direction, the front is the direction where the bonsai is normally viewed at, and people believe if you have a wider base or wider surface root, it's better to use as the front. So with not too much teasing, I've exposed a lot of root surface, which we can kind of see this direction. You kind of have a ridiculously broad base, and that would be a strong front. Also, this side would be pretty nice. The only thing that you may not be able to see from your angle is that on this side, I have there is a lack of root coming from this side, while on this side it kind of has a wide root base, and also some surface root on this side. So I think this angle, you're watching from this angle, may be a good front. So after deciding on a potential front, which decided based on the wide root base, and we would need to start doing some reduction of the branches. So this, I think this bonsai, I will style it not with a lot of traditional wisdoms, including, for example, no crossing branches, no crossing trunks. I think with a tree that grow in such a special way, those roots may not emphasize the unique characteristic, the randomness of the how the trunks and the branches grow. If we just adhere to all those rules, but still we will start with a reduction of the overly grown structure of the tree. So the first thing I see is that this is kind of out of character of the tree. So maybe I fertilized it a little bit too much this year. So we kind of got a branch here that's growing very straight up, and it's growing very long. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to cut that branch, to remove this branch that is obviously out of character. OOC. So you can see this is a very straight branch, which is probably a good candidate for making a cutting out of. So I'm probably going to save it for cutting later. So I've removed the majority of this branch, and now I'm going to go in and remove the stump of it, the leftover stump. That is that branch removed, and so we can see from the front, this tree kind of bifurcates, which is pretty nice. And then this branch has some nice movement, and then it bifurcates into two branches, and one branch grows upward, the other branch grows slightly upward and immediately bifurcate again, which make a very very strong characteristic of this tree. And then both branches is extremely charismatic, but it also has a not just bifurcate, but branch out into three major branches. So based on a very simple rules, anytime you have a place that has three branches, you want to reduce it to two, or you would risk of creating an inverse taper in the tree. So based on that, I'm going to reduce these three branches into two. And from my opinions, there is this branch on the back that has a lot more movement. There is a branch in the front that's very special, or almost grow horizontally out in the front. They are both very characteristic. So I'm going to reduce a branch that kind of grow in between of the two more charismatic branch. So I'm going to reduce that one to the base. Okay, I've cut out that branch. And I don't have to, if I want, I can also clean it a little bit. The branches are a little bit dense, so I may have some problem reaching into the exact location to clean that up. I can either clean it or maybe not right now. I can do it a little later. But I've cut out a major branch there. So that's the tree right now. Bear in mind that we can do both sides as the front. At this point, I don't have to decide yet. So both front, this side as the front, or the opposite side would be pretty charming. But if I use this side as the front, I would have to reduce the front branch quite a bit. So if I use somewhere here as the front, I would need to kind of open up the front. The front kind of got blocked by a lot of this branch that grow really in front of the tree. So I will start reducing some of the branches that kind of blocked the front, and I kind of need to identify where those branches come from and kind of start reducing it. Okay, I'm going to just quickly look from the front. So I'm currently looking, if my finger is pointing from the front view, I identified right now. And currently I'm looking from the front and trying to see what I can reduce first. Okay. First thing is, a lot of the branches are obviously too long, and and also maybe crossing the front of the tree. So I'm going going to first reduce those branches that block the front. Okay, all these are probably good cutting materials. Where does this come from? Okay, so there is this branch that actually come from the back of the tree. So I'm going to get rid of this branch. And now we have opened up the front a lot. So if you look at it from the front, it has been opened up a lot. Okay, there is a small branch that come from here. I can reduce, maybe reduce it to the main trunk line. Okay. Okay. There is also some branch that's growing backward. I'm not going to reduce every branch that grows backward, because some of it are very characteristic. This tree is unpredictable. I think it's some of the characteristic of this tree. You can hardly predict how this tree will grow. So a lot of branches, they actually grow backward into the tree, but it is in fact very characteristic of this tree. So I'm not going to completely remove a lot of the backward growing branch, although in a lot of the bonsai practice, if there is a branch that grows backward, it's an immediate kill. Immediately you will remove it, but I'm not going to do so. I'm going to keep a lot of the characteristic of this tree. So it is partly mind design, but part of it, it's nature's design. It's this tree. How does this tree come to be this style? And I would like to see a lot of the characteristic of the tree get preserved. So, for example, here you have a branch that's growing backward to itself, and I think it's very, very characteristic of the tree. So I'm not going to remove it, but I'm going to shorten the branch that come out too much. This is not per se a cascade tree, so I'm going to shorten a lot of the cascading branch. Those may be made into cuttings in the future. And this branch is very beautiful. I'm going to remove a branch that's growing backward. This branch. And I have saved this zigzagging branch that I feel that's very interesting. And I could take it all the way back to the zigzagging branch. I think I would do so.
will just take this back
almost all the way, but the leaf is dumb. Just in case it dies back. Okay, that is... That is the something that's go to the front of the tree. So the front now is completely open. So I would get rid of some of the dead branch on the back. And now I will need to decide on the decide on the profile of the tree. So there is this branch that doesn't belong to this tree. I can remove that's on the top. So there is this branch on the top that I think it's too long, I can reduce it. Okay. Reduce it. Going to the front, that I don't need it to be that long. I can also reduce it. This back branch is very long. From the front view. There are all these zigzagging branch. That I would need to I would first cut out the branches that are too long from the front. Okay, I see this branch is a little bit long. Is dead. This branch is unnecessary to cut it. Is a little bit too long. I'm gonna cut a little bit. see. So I'm going to turn this tree to its back. It's maybe easier to see from the back how I can make this, because the back, we have a branch that's very, very characteristic of this tree, which one day could be turned into the front if the roots improve. So I would need to consider this branch carefully. It is on the back, it is actually very, very characteristic of this tree. I will need to think about it very, very carefully. So I'm looking at it from the front again. So I think this don't have to be that long. Reduce it, and this don't have to be that long. I can reduce it. So there is, from the front view, there is two branches that almost coming parallel to each other, which is not necessary. So I'm going to reduce the one from the front. Okay. And from the front, we have this branch that don't have much movement and it's stumpy. I'm going to reduce that. The one that has a lot of movement, and now it is the ones that's on the back of the tree. It's a very good movement. So I'm going to find the branches that's with the best movement and preserve these branches. And reduce those ones that don't have the same movement. Okay, so this one, there is a lot of area that does not have much movement. I'm just going to reduce them. This one, I'm going to reduce. look at where the movements of the tree ends and reduce those things that does not have too good of a movement. So here you have a long section that does not have a lot of movement in branching. I'm just going to reduce it. This is very long and straight. Reduce it only. I'm only keeping those branches that has a lot of good movements. Otherwise, I'm going to reduce it back to maybe one or two pair of leaves. Okay, there is this back branch that is very long and don't have much movement, at least from the front view. So I'm going to reduce that. Continue to take a look. I want to take this as the leading branch, so I'm going to cut off anything that's taller than this branch. So with that decision in mind, I'm going to shorten a lot of the branches that are actually taller than this branch, including this major branch on the back, although its movement is very nice. Still have some branches that's going to the back. I'm going to look at it from the side and reduce some of those branches. Just keeping the profile in mind. There's a duck branch, I believe, here. This branch. I believe this one is almost dead, so reduce it. I think we have it. So I'm probably going to reduce this branch, although it's very characteristic of the tree, but it's a little bit too long. Here I'm going to reduce it a little bit too long. Still a little bit crowded. I'm going to reduce the back a little bit too. is a little bit uncharacteristic branch. I'm going to reduce. And now, I think we have what we are looking for right now. What I'm going to do, I'm not going to repot the tree right now, but I'm going to put a lot of the surface soil I remove back into the bottom of the pot it comes from. And then put it directly back into the pot. I'm trying to give you the front view of this tree right now. And let me come to the camera and see if you can look at it properly. Okay, I think this way you may be able to look at the front more properly. So this is the front view of this tree right now. We have a broad base, have basically three trunks. They are moving in very unpredictable manner, that which is the characteristic of this tree. Thus you see two of the trunks are crossing with each other, which is almost a death sentence of some of the trunks, but I'm going to keep it. Because this is such a strong characteristic of this tree. So now we have seen the tree from its front. I'm just going to put the tree back into its pot and basically put all the surface soil I remove into the bottom of the pot and put the tree directly back into the pot. Maybe put some good bonsai soil to cover the surface. Okay, that's what I'm going to do for the rest of the time. I'm going to put the camera back and trying to find a place to put the camera solidly, and sorry, that may give you a headache, but I'm just trying to find a solid place to put the camera. Okay. Now I'm just going to pick the tree and put the soils back.
So this operation may reduce the winter hardiness of the tree a little bit. Because a lot of the leaves, they are removed. Thus the tree may not be as hardy. It may not, from now to the winter, it may not have as much sugar generated and stored. So I may need to protect the tree a little bit. I'm just going to put some good bonsai soil on the surface just to protect the exposed root a little bit. When the spring comes, I'm going to repot it into complete bonsai soil. Because this is not the season for repotting, I'm simply not going to do any drastic work to the roots. I think I still have enough time to do the pruning I did today, and the tree will have some time to recover. In the very cold winter, I may need to protect this tree. I may need to protect the tree. In a room that's not. That's an unheated room. Okay, so this is the tree. The last thing I will do, I may just seal some of the big wounds that I created today. Just going to seal it. Two major wounds. One is here. I'm going to seal. Because the color of the trunk, once we seal it, the wound is almost invisible. So the color of the trunk is almost black. And the wound sealant is also almost black, so it is probably very good camouflage of the cut. Okay, I'm just going to seal the major ones, the minor ones. If I don't remember where the cuts are, I may not seal. But if I see a green wound, I will just seal it. For the prevention of infection and also for cosmetic reason. Okay, if there are no other major wound, I'm just going to leave it like that. Some exposed roots on the back, so I will just cover these roots with some more soil. Otherwise, it would be fine. Do one more rotation of the tree, and we will call this done. Okay, so we can see. So here is the front I decided on. I'm just going to try to tune it to the proper size. Okay, so here is the front I decided on, and it is almost like a Chinese character, with all those crossing trunk line, which a lot of the times people would deem very ugly. But for this tree, it is very, very characteristic of the tree. So I'm going to preserve this characteristic because we are currently raining, so I'm not going to water this plant. You can see it almost on every direction. It is beautiful. So this is, I think, this is another possible front, but the root base is not as good, so I'm not choosing it. And choose the other side as the front. Very, very crazy branch structure. Okay, I think we are back to the front now. So this is the first styling of this wire netting bush. I think I saw. Another thing, you can see the branch structure is ideal for bonsai. The leaf size is very small. And there is one more characteristic of this tree is that it has yellow flower in the summer. So this year I saw one, but I think as this tree grow, we may see more and more flower in the future. So I saw one video of a full-size wire netting bush bonsai, so I'm probably going to attach the link in the description below, so that you can see a full-size tree. The other thing, I may just search some of the introduction of the growing habit of this tree and also include them in the description below. And I hope you enjoy this video, and I hope this tree survive, and next spring I will find a proper bonsai pot and repot the tree. Hope you enjoy this video, and also hope you take care of yourself, and I will see you next time. Bye.